Hello traders, today is the 17th of October 2010 and happy trading to you all. This video is to show you quickly the position of the Euro USD. As you can see where my cursor is, the Euro is at a very important resistance level. The zone that we are talking about, we are not talking about price level, we are talking about the zone of this zone from 13988 to 14160. Okay, 13988 to 14160. This is a very important resistance level for the Euro USD. This is the weekly chart of the Euro USD. As you can see, last week we have what we call the indecision. Okay, with this candle here. As you can see, this is the indecision candle here. Like I told you before, the Euro is going up only because of the quantitative easing, which means the Fed is willing to print money, so the market is willing to buy the euro and to sell the dollar. Okay, so because the Fed is willing to print more dollar, the dollar should go down and the euro should go up versus the dollar. That's why this currency pair is going. Okay, if there was no intention to print more dollar, okay, the euro should be coming down. Okay, so all this movement to the upside is backed by the news, okay, the economics news, that the Fed is willing to print more dollar, what we call the quantitative easing. Okay, the English the Bank of England have done that already. Okay, so United Kingdom is ahead of the game. As I told you before, that was the main thing everybody should have done before. As the market went into a meltdown, quantitative easing was the best thing to do straight away to deal with the problem instead of cutting corners, okay, so to speak. Okay, so right now everybody want to print more money. I believe that was the right solution at the beginning of the crisis, to print more money straight away to deal with the problem. Okay, and now it's too a bit late for the Fed to be printing money now, but this is what's going to happen, so I cannot put pressure on the Fed. Okay, the same thing for the euro. Okay, we know that Jean-Claude Trichet is a bit stubborn to print money in order to devalue the dollar, the euro, but we know that at one point the European Central Bank has to print money also. So the United Kingdom has made the right decision by printing money at early stage of the crisis. Okay, so now the United States also is preparing to do exactly like we have done in London here, print more money, deal with the problem, and then they will see what will come out of that. Okay, that was the bad decision the Bank of England has taken, and I believe that the Fed should do exactly the same. So if the Fed is willing to print more money, we should see the euro continuing the movement to the upside. At this particular point, it is very important to follow the price, to keep your eyes wide open, as the technical and the fundamental are getting into conflict, which means right here we have a valid reason to look for opportunity to sell. But we know also that because of the quantitative easing, the euro may continue the movement to the upside. So three things can happen here. At a key resistance level, the price is likely to break the resistance level and go above it and find support above that resistance level and continue the movement to the upside, or it may fail to break the resistance level, which means the price will collapse, continue the movement to the downside. Okay, we come to this level now, it will turn around and come down, or it may continue the movement above the resistance level, okay, and only to fail to find a support above the resistance level, which means the price going above the resistance level and then crashing back down. Okay, so it will fail to find a support and then break the resistance level to the downside again. Okay, so three things, remember: it can go above the resistance level and find a support, or it can go above the resistance level and fail to find a support, or it will find resistance right there at the resistance level and turn around. So this is it. The signal is one thing, but the entry point is the most important thing. That's why it's so important to follow the price itself, the number one indicator, together with your TST W24 trading system. At this particular point in trading, Do not assume anything. Do not get into any conclusion. Wait for the market to open, London to open, New York to open, and follow the price. Keep your eyes wide open. You're at the key resistance level. The same thing for the Dow Jones Index, for the NASDAQ Index, for all the major currency. Same thing, watch gold, watch the crude oil. That's why I pay attention carefully to the Euro USD. Okay, once I watch this, I know the pattern here. I know straight away what is likely to happen also on the major indices. Same thing for gold, same thing for the crude oil. I hope you find this video useful, especially this week. We are at a resistance level, which means we are bearish, okay? We are bearish, but it does not mean that the price cannot break a resistance level. The price can perfectly break the resistance level and find a support above the resistance level. This is the mistake that most swing traders are making. They see the price coming to a resistance level, they will quickly place order to sell, only to see the price break that resistance level confidently and continue the movement to the upside. The tendency to try to forecast the market is just ridiculous. You cannot forecast the market. The best thing to do is to wait for the price to break the resistance or to turn around at the resistance level, which means the trend line being broken, giving us a clear-cut entry point. Our signal is one trade, but the entry point is the most important thing. We wish you a very happy trading week. Until the next time, enjoy yourself and be very happy. Thank you.